I want to start with a small story. I'm a storyteller. I mean, that was one part which perhaps got missed in the introduction. I write one story every day, and I've been doing that for years now. So I'll start with one small story. I was about 8 years old, walking down the road with my father, with a ball in my hand. We were living next to a stadium in Ludhiana, Punjab. And he was taking me to that stadium to play something with me. And suddenly ball slipped from my hands and it went on the other side of the road. There was another boy, young boy like me only, small boy. I was a small boy that time. And he picked up the ball and returned to me. I took it and I started walking. My dad stopped and thanked that boy. And then my father told me, he said, "I wonder why have you not thanked him? Anybody doing something good to you, anybody being nice to you, you must always express your gratitude. And I think you must not be even praying right in the morning when you get up and express your gratitude to God." From that day onwards, I started living like that. And I have not missed even one day without expressing my gratitude, and it will be very appropriate for me to do that here also. Let me tell you, Model United Nations is going to teach you a lot about being a public speaker, being a debater, being a leader, being a good communicator. It will teach you also about critical thinking, or it will also, you know, teach you about leadership. And maybe at some point you will also learn what needs to be taught, what doesn't need to be taught, when to speak, when to stop, because these are all things which are going to happen as you practice different models in MUN. But then my focus is going to be on basics. All this will not be possible if certain basics are not being practiced by us throughout our lives, starting from your age or maybe less than that. As I said, I am going to tell you all these things with stories, with the help of stories. Stories from my own life. I generally like to pick up stories from my own life. Every day, whatever story I have written is from my own experiences, life experiences. For me, there is nothing which can teach you better than life itself. Teachers are definitely very important in our life. At the same time, we need to also be learners from our own experiences. It's very important, therefore, that I share with you certain very interesting things which have happened with me and which perhaps ultimately have resulted in my coming here today. This becomes the end result of my life. Do we agree on this? This moment is actually the end result of all of my living. And maybe all that has happened with me because I needed to be here, accepting this great honor. It all happened when I was 6 to 7 years. My all stories are going to be from 7 to 8 years to 15 years, okay? Because that is the age group I think I am dealing with here, right? I was 8 years old. My father comes back from his office. He was a big businessman. And he one fine day calls me and he tells me, "Meshi," I used to be called Meshi, Ramesh's short form, right? He said, "Meshi, come here and sit with me." I said, "Yes, Papa, what is it?" He says, "Tell me what all you have done from morning till now." I was surprised, he had never asked me earlier. I don't know why he chose that particular day to start this activity. I made a list and I started telling him right from the morning what I have done. Then he asked me a very interesting question which I have been asking till today since that day, right? Every day. He said, "Tell me what was right and what was wrong in it. What were the things you did right and what were the things you did wrong?" Now at 8 years age, you don't have a lot of understanding, correct? So with my limited understanding, I would tell him, "This is right and this was wrong." And he will correct me at certain places. "No, this was not right. This is how it was not right." He gave me very strong rights and wrongs, and he did this exercise with me for almost a couple of years, and then left it to me to do it on my own every day, and that is what I have been doing till today. Right living is what it taught me, and I will tell you in this exercise what other things it taught me as I realized when I was moving forward. Second thing which I want to tell you is, it was my 9th birthday. I didn't know that what kind of a pleasant surprise was coming in for me, because my father used to be a person, in fact, a person who never did anything wrong ever, including health habits. He did not even watch a movie ever. So he gave me a surprise. Newspaper hawker threw the paper inside. I was carrying along with paper comes two magazines, Nandan and Champak. People of my age will remember that. I was surprised. I said, from where these have come? And my father comes from inside and he says, these are gifts for you. Today onwards you are going to start reading. He gifted me my reading habit. I said, Dad, so what will happen if I read? He said, you are going to learn a lot of things. And it's not that. He said, I am going to ask you every night what you have read today and you have narrated to me. Quite obviously, that is what was storytelling. I was telling him a story every day, and today I am a storyteller. This is how life shapes up. Trust me for this. Personally, I have never slept without reading from that day, ever, even in hospital. I was 15 days in hospital, suffering from a mild heart attack, and I was reading every day there also. Now, how this helped me? I became a learner. That is what you need to become. Whatever be your achievement, whatever level you are, if you are not learning, then you are not living. That is what I believe in. Because unless you learn, you don't grow. Right? You are young, you are growing, but at a certain age, maybe 24, 25, you stop growing physically. And growth is a sign of living beings. Correct? If you are not growing, you are not living. So after 22, 23, if you are growing, then where you need to grow? That is your mind. So you need to become a learner, and that is what you made me. And then, one fine day, I was sleeping beauty sleep, and suddenly I found my bed sheet being pulled out like this. I was around 10 years. We had shifted to a new house next to stadium, as I told you. We were living next to stadium, and he pulled the bed sheet and he tells me, get up, time 5:30 a.m. What is that time? Is it the time to wake? I said, what, Dad, my school is at 8:30 and you get up at 7:30. What is this 5:30? No. You have to every day start going to stadium and you are going to run. 10 years old and you are going to get into some kind of a sports activity. That what will happen with that? You will learn self-discipline. He wanted me to be self-disciplined. He said, today I have woken you up, tomorrow onwards you are going to do it on your own. Or I will keep doing till you get into the habit. He gave me that habit of sports. Now something, you know, very interesting happened. When I was going every day to stadium, I made new friends. And you know, sometimes you get fascinated with some friends at that age. In that particular, your age group, right? You get focused on certain friends, and whatever they do, you want to do that. So I started with basketball, and suddenly I found my friend wanted to play cricket. And he pushed me to cricket. I started playing cricket, won an award in cricket, sub juniors. And suddenly a badminton tournament happened. Mr. Prakash Padukone came, and we all got fascinated, and my friend said, to hell with cricket. Both only to drink. I had broken my finger. I got a dimple here. Thanks to that cricket leather ball. We never played with tennis ball in Punjab. It was always a leather ball. So I started playing badminton. Won a sub-junior title, and suddenly one fine day, a coach comes, TT coach, he says, anybody knows TT? I said, I know TT. He said, how I have been playing on dining table every day in the evening with my family. He said, come, let me see, how do you play? When I played with him, then he told me, he said, do you know one thing? You have wasted so many hours, years. I said, why? He said, because this is the game that suits you. Your height, your quickness, the way you look at the ball so quickly and act and pick it up, I can get you in district team in 6 months. But you have to be focused. My coach told me about focus. He said, please, no more distractions. No more pursuing of what friends are doing. What your friend is good at, you may not be good at that. It's all natural talents, right? So don't follow your friends to be what you want to be. You be what you need to be. That is what my coach told me, that stay focused on one thing till you achieve. And I went after TT and I played national at the age of 17. 3 years only. You know, we need to be focused, we need not distract. At your age, you are going to keep on shifting, you know, you will give up things very quickly. You start one thing and you will give it up. You start second thing, you will give it up. Don't do that. Stay focused, work hard on one thing, and reach your great heights, wherever you can reach. So we have talked about self-discipline and focus, right? And to be a learner. Let me tell you something very interesting. What was happening between those rights and wrongs every day? My father was very subtly telling me that for doing what is right, you need self-discipline. To go forward, you need to do the right thing, you need self-discipline. But at the same time, to stop doing what is wrong, you need a self-control. Now, how I came to know about that he had been very subtly, you know, pushing me towards exercising self-control. We were in ninth, and one fine day, you know, those some bullies in class, they always are there, and we have to face them. They announced before recess, one period before recess, we all are going to bunk the class. Where we are going to playground, and there is a bet between two these boys, and we have had bets who will be the other person in 100 meter race. Now, to have that bet completed, we have to bunk the class because in recess we will not get the place. I said, sorry, I'm not coming. Said, what do you mean? I said, it is wrong. It's my father who has paid for this class. I have not paid. I can't betray him. I am not coming. They said, Ramesh, puri class tumse baat nahi karegi. Nobody will talk to you. I said, fine. What do you mean? I said, fine. Don't talk to me. I am not coming. Everybody left. I was sitting alone in the class and teacher comes. She said, where is everybody else? I said, they have gone to ground. Why did you not go? I said, I didn't want to. And she did not like it. You know why? Because she had to spend the hour with me. There was a student in the class. Did I care? No, I did not care. Because I was very much focused on doing the right thing. Now, something very interesting happens. Nobody talks to me every day, 15 days, 20 days, 25 days. And 30th day, in class, an announcement was made that I was declared captain of the district school team in TT. Within 6 months, I was 14 years old, I started, and within 6 months, I had become captain of school team of the district, and that was announced in the class. Now what happened? My best friend, who was under pressure for not talking to me, walks to me and congratulates me. And then he makes everybody else also to feel good about this, that our class had a captain of the six school team in TT. So everybody started talking to me. And the self-control, it was self-control which worked. I was not supposed to be going into wrong things. It is very important, and this is and where it helped me? It helped me to stay away from any bad health habit till today. At the age of 58, I have won a TT tournament. Let me tell you, beating a young champion who had not lost for the last 2 years. So you need to be self-disciplined. You need to be having focus, and you need to have tremendous self-control if you want to be a leader, a debater, a public speaker, or whatever you want to be. Without these three things, you just cannot be. And lastly, something very interesting happened with me again in it. That was the time I think my foundation was being laid, how I was to lead the life. I went to a new school, and Madam will know, Government Model High School, and there I made a very good friend. After about 3 months of our friendship, one fine day he tells me, Saturday, that we are leaving early, why don't you come to my house in the evening and we'll play? So I asked him about what time you want me to be there. He said about 2:30. His house was 5 kilometers, and I had a bicycle to ride on for 5 kilometers. I went home, and suddenly I found my sister telling me, Ramesh, we all are going for a movie, are you coming? I said, I'm sorry, I'm not coming. She said, why? I said, my friend has promised me. I have made a promise to my friend that I am going to his house. So I was outside his lane when I found him coming out of his bungalow along with his sister, and suddenly a car comes in a reverse, his dad is driving, and they both open the door and they both sit inside the car, and the car starts coming towards me, and suddenly my friend looks at me and he says, "Arey, you are here?" Car stops, he makes his father stop the car, and he says, "Arey, you are here?" I said, "Yeah." "Oh, I forgot. I am going for a movie with my father. Thank you for coming." I had left the movie for my friend, right? And he left me for being his family. In a very subtle way, God had given me a message which I have kept till today with me. Family first. Are you understanding this? At your age, very important to know. Family first, parents first. And I don't know how many of you have watched that beautiful movie called Pico. In that there was a lesson, we don't judge our parents. Parents first. Because actually, it is their effort that is bringing us up here along with teachers, along with you. When parents send you to school, they expect you to be coming out as very responsible citizens, polished youngsters, right? Now school is given the responsibility of nurturing you, but then it is not possible for school alone, it is not possible for parents alone, because you are a product which need to cooperate with teachers as well as the parents to become responsible citizens. So self-discipline, self-control, focus, family first, and your own effort towards self-development, staying away from bad habits, to help your body to take you to the age you want to live up to. Like I remember telling my father, I would like to be living up to the age of 85 like my grandmother. And he said, what are you going to do to your body for that? I said, I will take care of it. So please take care of your bodies, your mind, your health, yourself. Thank you very much. I am sure that you will become very responsible citizens. God bless.